हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, माई सेल्फ ज्ञानरंजन सर। टुडे वी विल लर्न चैप्टर 2 इन केमिस्ट्री फॉर क्लास 6। द चैप्टर 2 इज एलिमेंट्स, कंपाउंड्स एंड मिक्सचर्स। सो वी हैव टू नो व्हाट इज एलिमेंट्स, व्हाट इज कंपाउंड्स एंड व्हाट इज मिक्सचर्स। रिमेंबर, एलिमेंट्स एंड कंपाउंड्स टू आर प्योर सब्सटेंस, बिकॉज एलिमेंट्स एंड कंपाउंड्स cannot be separated into its components by any physical means. So elements and compounds are pure substance. So what is elements? So we will learn what is elements. So elements are pure substance which can neither be broken down into further simpler substance nor formed from two or more simpler substance. That means elements are pure substance that can neither be broken down into simpler form, and it is pure, made up of pure substances, and we cannot separate by any physical or chemical means. So elements, so these are the examples written here. Iodine made up of only iodine particles, lead, aluminium, chlorine, copper, oxygen, sulfur, mercury, magnesium, iron. These are the examples of elements. All substance on the earth are chemically made up of either one elements or two or more elements. So as for now, as for 120 elements discovered, out of which 92 are naturally occurring and the rest have been prepared artificially by men. Some elements are artificially created by scientists. Example, the radioactive elements that are discovered or created by scientists. Here in more to know, there are different kind of substance to study the substance without placing them in similar groups would make the study of matter very difficult. So for simplicity, scientists divided these into elements, compounds and mixtures. The most abundant element in the earth crust are silicon. Only remember, silicon, aluminium, iron, carbon, sodium and potassium are earth most abundant elements. In the universe, hydrogen and helium are the main elements which are present in the stars and make up 98% of their mass. Now some examples of solid, liquid and gaseous elements. So solid elements examples are gold, silver, iron, copper, lead. These are the example of solid elements. Liquid elements are mercury and bromine. These are the liquid elements. And gaseous elements are oxygen, nitrogen, hydrogen, chlorine, fluorine. These are the gaseous elements. So what are the characteristics? Characteristics of elements are: an element is a pure substance, it is made up of only one kind of particle, and it may occur naturally or prepared artificially, and it exists in three states: solid, liquid and gaseous state. Okay, now we classify elements. First we have to classify the elements in four types. First is metal, second one is non-metals, third is metalloids, and last one is noble or inert gases. So first, metals. So metals, what is metals? Metals are generally solid, hard solids at room temperature, and they are having lustrous surface. Lustrous surface means their shining surface. Substance which have shine, that is their shining surface, that is lustrous surface. And next is they are malleable. Malleable means they can be hammered or rolled into thin sheets without breaking. So these are called lustrous property. Then next is ductile. Ductile means it can be drawn into thin wires, small wires, without breaking. That is called ductile property. So they are lustrous, that is metals shine, and they are malleable, that is it can be hammered or rolled into thin sheet without breaking. And ductile means it can be drawn into thin wires. And next is they have a high boiling point and melting points, and are good conductor of heat and electricity. Always remember, one exception is there. All metals are solid, but mercury is a metal that is in liquid form. You have to remember, the metal, that is mercury, which is in liquid form, and all others metal are solid form. Okay, that is written here. And sodium, remember, and sodium metal is soft, not hard metals. Usually metals are hard solids, but sodium metal is soft, and we can cut sodium in a knife also. Okay, so it is of silver color when fast cut, but loses its luster as it react with air. When it gradually react with air, its luster property loses. It loses the luster property. Okay, examples of metals are silver, gold, platinum, zinc, tin, sodium, calcium, iron, magnesium. These are the examples of metals. Next, non-metals. Non-metals having dull surface because they no sign. There is no sign, that is called dull surface, except graphite and iodine. And always remember, non-metals are always in liquid and gaseous form. But some non-metals are there which are solid. Examples, graphite. Okay, they are solid. But every non-metals are liquid or gaseous. Next, first, non-metals having dull surface except graphite and iodine. They are non-metals, but their surface are not dull. They shine. Okay. Or they possess luster, but exception. No, graphite and iodine. We have to remember. And non-metals are usually non-malleable. Non-malleable, when we rolled or hammered it into thin sheet, they break. Okay. So, they are non-malleable. And non-ductile also. Non-ductile means they cannot be drawn into thin wire forms. Okay. And their boiling and melting point are low, and they are bad conductor of heat and metals are good conductor of heat and electricity, but non-metals are bad conductor of heat and electricity. Okay, except graphite is a non-metal, but it is good conductor. So you have to remember the exception. In metal, exception are mercury, which is solid, but which is metal but in liquid form, and sodium, which is not hard solid. But in non-metal, you have to remember the graphite. Graphite is a non-metal, but it is a good conductor of heat and electricity. Okay. So, they are generally solid or gaseous, except bromine, which is a liquid. They are usually solid and gaseous, but bromine. Bromine is a non-metal, but in liquid form. Okay. Now, examples written here, hydrogen, oxygen, sulfur, nitrogen. These are examples of non-metals. Okay. Now, next, difference, metal and comparative study. What is the comparison between metals and non-metals? First, I already told, metal having shining surface, but dull surface, non-metals having dull surface, excluding graphite and iodine, and they have high density, non-metals having low density. There is high melting point, but having low melting point. These are metals having high boiling point, these are low boiling point, and they are ductile, and they are non-ductile, and malleable, non-malleable. And metals are good conductor of heat and electricity, but non-metals are bad conductor of heat and electricity. Okay, now we come to next, metalloids. What is metalloids? So, metalloids are a group of element that lie between metal, metallic and non-metal. That is, metalloid possesses the characteristics of both metal and non-metals. So, they show property that are to some extent to metallic and some extent to non-metallic. So, they are metalloids. Example, boron, silicon, germanium, arsenic and antimony. These are the examples of metalloids. Now, noble or inert gases. Noble or inert, what is noble or inert gases? These are those gases, elements that do not react chemically with other elements and are stable. Always it remains stable. That is, it don't react with other elements. Examples, helium, neon, argon, krypton, xenon, radon. Okay, these are noble or inert gases. The scientific zone, you have to remember, J.J. Thomson, a British scientist, was credited with the discovery of the electron. Goldstein discovered the proton, and James Chadwick identified the neutron.